talked about how
I want to bring this in. That's probably your most high percentage escape that you're going to come across. People are going to be looking for the saddle. Okay? So let's just say I have Carl and I say, Ashi, we're here. We're waiting on that response. The second his leg comes over, okay, I'm keeping my triangle to keep my legs safe. Carl's going to do the same. Because if he doesn't, I can start attacking that leg that's open. So he'll be triangling. Now from there, I'm just going to lean back, drag the legs across. Now we are into 50-50. If you've gained from there, you can just go down the whole pathway at 50-50. There's a ton of stuff you can do from here. But again, I'm going to be keeping my legs safe. Card's doing the same. Now we're into, especially with triangle, I'm trying to split his legs, he's trying to split mine. That's dangerous from this position. So I'm going to be looking to make a grip on his arm. Then I just fall to that same side and bring his body over my legs, over the junction. So now his legs are free to split. So that hand comes underneath. So it's underhooking both legs, he just grabbed that heel. Okay, the second one splits, re-grabs, and then I find the shin. And now it's just a matter of me doing this. Again, you'll get people that just will not let you come up into the saddle. Car's being really heavy on my legs here. Okay. And it's very difficult for me to get up to pass my legs in between. But we're very close to the outside Ashi from there, so I just lean back, bring this across. Just sit up, car, and I'm in the outside Ashi. Now if I really want the saddle to be already covered, this one of the spinning entries, I can just straighten one leg, post, and now sit up on car and I'm in the combat base. Sit back and down into the saddle on this side, covered on a weak race. If you want to add that in, that's cool. Let's look at that again. So, let's just say I have Carl and outside Ashi. He brings that in. I triangle my legs. Carl triangles his legs. I sit back, drag him into 50-50, and sit up. I definitely do not want to be lying down here. We covered this in all the leg entanglements. This is the danger arm on this leg. So that's the one I want to grab first, if that makes sense. So again, from there, just bring Carl on top of that leg to keep it safe. Come underneath, make the grip. Other hand comes between the legs, places that grip, and then he finds the shin, keep your ankles crossed, bro. And now that's just a peel to split the legs. If Carl keeps me on this side and he physically can't get off my right hip, I just lean back and drag this across. But maybe I suck at the front Ashi position, alright, and I want to get into the saddle, okay? So it's just a matter of straightening my left leg, keeping control of the knee line, and bringing my right knee up to here. Now if Carl's laying back, I got it's even easier, because he's not sitting up. I just sit on him and switch into combat base. Remember making the wedges inside of my knee and my heel. I sit back and we're into the saddle. So I have outside Ashi. Carl sits, Carl swims inside. I keep my legs, he keeps his legs safe. Lean back, now lean back. Can't drag the legs through your body. Immediately I sit up and look for arm control. Bring him on top. Find the heel. Replace. Split. I can't do the last move. Car's being really heavy on my legs, especially heavy guys. They're lying with your legs. It's very hard to come up into the saddle. From there, I just swim this leg back from the far side to the near side. I'm in the outside action. More than likely, this car, he wants to sit up and play his hold, bringing the foot in again. We already covered that if I keep my hand here and he comes, brings that inside, we already have those grips to talk about. But from there, before he does that, I just control the knee line. Straighten my left leg and bring my right knee up. Now I can physically sit up into my combat base position and now bring him back into this saddle.